So here I am, messing with the pedals. Let's turn everything off. Pretty kind of a dry tone. Here's my amp. On this guitar, I'm just using the middle position, which on this guitar is both of these with an active tone control. So it's pretty standard on this. You've got three positions. So you've got front, middle, bridge pickup, and all of them are interactive with the tone. So it's more of a modern, even though it's a vintage Fender Tele, it's more of the modern. Daniel, take your drink. Get off the scene here. You're in the video. Oof. Thank you. You're still in it. Go. Okay. So it's kind of a modern wiring for this Tele, which is okay. But I'm going to use mostly just the both pickups. And a pretty decent sounding little amp on its own, you know. Saturated a little bit. Not bad. I could use a little tamer reverb there. That's better. Nice little EQ going on here. Give it a little bottom end. There's the bridge pickup. That nice little visual Tele snap there. See, pull this EQ out and Tele snap, but I was going to put it right both pickups. If I was going to add a little chorus, a little delay, and maybe some distortion, get up into the neck pickup, kind of a sort of a Mark Knopfler. Internet one time, bid an auction. I think it started at $5 and I wanted it $7 with shipping and everything. It's delivered to my door for like less than $10, but it's one of the best little boosty kind of distortion pedals I've ever had. Thank you. Never can play that thing perfectly. Anyway. Nice little distortion when you need that extra kick. No, I'll just throw the A tone on, A C tone on, I should say. Gives it just that nice little... Very basic little amp, so it's a good little practice sound. Like I was saying, on that neck pickup, boy, she sure makes a mess. Fairly convincing Knopfler type of effect. Just email me, and I think I'm going to call it wrapped up now because the young guy's been sitting pretty quietly, so I think I better get to them. Thanks.
See ya.